Hi friends, welcome back to my new lecture. Today we are going to discuss about counter fluid exchanger, and in a counter fluid exchanger we are going to discuss what is LMTD for counter fluid exchanger. Now in the last lecture we have discussed about what is heat exchanger and what is LMTD. So long form of LMTD is logarithmic mean temperature difference, and a counter flow means what? Both fluid are moving in opposite direction. Today we are going to discuss a derivation, or we are going to derive a derivation for LMTD for counter flow. I had drawn here heat exchanger, that is tube in tube type of heat exchanger. In a tube in tube type of heat exchanger, inner tube, this is inner tube in which hot fluid is flowing, and this hot fluid is moving from left to right. So arrow is shown with the red color. So this is hot fluid inlet, and this is what hot fluid outlet, that is flowing through the inside. Whereas cold fluid is entering towards right side and it is moving towards left, and it is coming out like this. So cold fluid is moving towards left, whereas the hot fluid is moving towards right. So as the direction of both are different, it is called as counter flow heat exchanger. In a counter fluid exchanger, there are terms like THI is hot fluid inlet temperature, THO, T indicates temperature, H indicates hot, and O indicates outlet. So it is a hot fluid outlet temperature. This is a TCI. What is TCI? The cold fluid inlet temperature, and TCO is cold fluid outlet temperature. Okay, now I have drawn a graph also for this. So in this we can see the various term. On the x-axis we have plotted a length of heat exchanger, and on the y-axis we have plotted the temperature. Let's focus on a hot fluid temperature. The hot fluid inlet temperature, the hot fluid inlet point is here. So you can see here the hot fluid is entering here, the hot fluid inlet temperature is here, and as it moves forward, the hot fluid as it moves forward, it loses its heat, or it gives its heat to the cold fluid, and that's why the hot fluid temperature goes on reduces, whereas cold fluid temperature goes on increases. So hot fluid which is entering towards left and coming out from right, as it moves forward the temperature drops, and the graph shows that it is a decrease in a temperature. Whereas the cold fluid which is entering from the right side, here the TCI is the inlet temperature, and as it moves forward it takes the heat from hot fluid, and hence its temperature goes on increases, and at the outlet we get TCO. So here we will see that the hot fluid temperature is decreasing from left to right, whereas the cold fluid temperature increasing from right to left. So both are moving opposite to each other, and as it moves both are opposite to each other, it is called as counter flow heat exchanger. For the analysis purpose, we have considered the small area dA. So this is the small area dA on the heat exchanger. For this dA, if I plot a temperature difference, so here for hot fluid this is the 2 point, and if I take temperature difference between these two, that this temperature minus this temperature, obviously this temperature is small compared to this temperature, and that's why it will come a negative value. And as it comes negative value, we are written here minus dTh. Similarly for the cold fluid, if I take point here and here, here also if I take this point minus this point temperature, so it will be negative, and that's why we are written here minor dTc. So minor dTc is the temperature difference for the small area, whereas minor dTh is temperature difference for hot fluid for this small area. Another term to understand is the slope of this particular line is negative, and that's why negative sign will come. At the same time slope of this line also negative, and hence we have written what? Minus dTc. So this is what we have discussed about its line diagram and various term into this one. Now let's derive an equation for LMTD of the counter flow heat exchanger. When we are discussing this, you must know some of the standard equations, like you must know that Q is equal to overall heat transfer coefficient into area into delta T. This standard equation. Some of the standard equation I am writing. So U is overall heat transfer coefficient, E is the surface area, and delta D is the temperature difference. Another equation for Q is MCP delta T, that you are knowing it. This is another standard equation, that this equation already you have discussed. This you have discussed in convection, this we have discussed in the thermodynamic subject. So you must know these two equations, and I am considering that you are knowing these two equations, and then I am going to derive this. So let's consider, I am going to start with the overall heat transfer equation. Just now we have written that Q is equal to UA delta T, As I told you, here the various term Q is heat transfer, U is overall heat transfer coefficient, A is the surface area, and delta D is the temperature difference. Okay. Now, the delta T, as I told you, it's temperature difference. It is temperature difference between hot fluid minus cold fluid. So, TH is the hot fluid temperature, TC is the cold fluid temperature. If I take derivative of this, it will become D of delta T is equal to DTH minus DTC. So, what we have done is just I added a derivative of here D of delta T, DTH minus DTC. This has the equation. Now, let's assume that that's the equation number 1. Now, I have to find out value of DTH and DTC and put into this particular equation. So, next task is finding equation for DTH and DTC. For this, I have to write an equation dQ is equal to mC dT. So, what is this equation? dQ is the heat transfer for the small area dA. mC delta T, that is the standard equation we are doing. I have written it as dT. So, this is temperature difference for the small area dA and this is the heat transfer for the small area dA which we have seen in the figure. Now, if I apply this particular equation for hot fluid, so applying equation for hot fluid. So, what will be equation now? So, here dQ heat transfer, this will become mass flow rate of hot fluid, specific heat of hot fluid and DTH. When I am writing a DTH from the graph, as we have seen here, that from the graph DTH is negative. At the same time DTC is also negative. Why negative? Because of negative slope. So, here I am going to add the negative sign here and this negative sign is because DTH is negative. So, this is because of negative slope. Now, I am going to define one more term that is what called as capacity CH and this is capital CH. Capital CH is nothing but mass flow rate of hot fluid, specific heat of hot fluid. So, capital CH is also called as heat capacity. So, this I am going to put in above equation. So, equation will become now dQ is nothing but minus CH dTH. Okay, this is the equation. Now, let's rearrange the term for DTH. So, DTH is equal to minus dQ upon CH. This is the equation number 2, what we have got it. So, now, we have find out value of what? DTH. Now, I have to find out value for DTC. Similar way, as we have seen it, here, this equation, we applied for hot fluid and now applying this equation for cold fluid. So, for cold fluid, I can write as dQ is equal to mC CC dTC. What I have done, this equation I applied for cold fluid and dTC is negative and that's why I have put here negative. So, this is negative slope. This is because of what? Negative slope. Now, in this case, also we are going to define capital CC and what is capital CC? It's similar to what? This term. Similar to this term that capital CH is MHCS, capital CC is MCCC. So, in this equation, I am going to replace MCCC by using CC and DTC is as it is. So, the next equation will become now as dQ is equal to dQ is equal to. So, this MCCC I am going to replace by capital CC and DTC. So, this will become minus CC DTC. Rearrange the term for DTC. So, DTC is equal to dQ upon capital CC and that's the negative and that's the equation number 3. Now, we have got value of DTH and DTC both. So, let's put into equation number 1. So, now by equation number 1, 2, and 3. So, what is equation number 1? Equation number 1 D of delta T DTH minus DTC. What is equation number 2? This is equation number 2. DTH is nothing but dQ by CH. And what is DTC? DTC is nothing but minus dQ by CC. So, this DTC and DTH I am going to put into this one. So, what will get an equation for D of delta T? So, D of delta T is equal to, rather than dth by the equation number 2, I can write minus dq by capital CH minus dtc. So what is dtc? This is minus dq. So minus and minus, it will become positive. So dq upon cc. So simplifying this equation now, d of delta t is equal to, taking common as dq. So after taking common as dq, what will remain? The remaining thing is 1 upon ch minus. Why minus? Because this minus sign we have taken outside. So this positive will become negative upon cc. This is what equation we have got. And let's consider, this is equation number 4. Now, next task with us is finding value of CH and CC, or finding equation for CH and CC and putting into this particular equation. So, next task is finding equation for CH and capital CC. So, for finding this particular equation, I am going to use another standard equation, that the heat transfer Q, we know that heat transfer Q is mass into specific heat into change in temperature. So this is delta T. That particular standard equation, we are knowing it. Now if I apply this standard equation for the hot fluid, that heat transfer from hot fluid is nothing but mass of hot fluid, specific heat of hot fluid and change in temperature of hot fluid. So if I refer this particular figure now, change in temperature of hot fluid. So hot fluid entry is here and exit is here. What is the change in hot fluid temperature? At the inlet it is dt, at the inlet it is THI, at the outlet it is THO. So it changes from THI to THO. In the graph we have seen that the temperature has gone reducing. So here I have to take positive temperature difference, and for taking a positive temperature difference I have to take higher temperature minus lower temperature, that is THI minus THO. So for the hot fluid, this difference will come as a THI minus THO. Now we have already known that MH into CH is capital CS, that we have written here, that MH into CH is capital CH. Okay, then THI minus THO as it is. Now I have to find out value of CH, and for finding value of CH, rearranging term for CH. So capital CH is nothing but Q upon THI minus THO. So what I have done, this term I have taken on this side. As I have taken this side, so it will become Q upon THI minus THO. This is the equation number 5. Similarly, this principle applying for cold fluid. So whatever we have done till now, same thing I am going to apply for cold fluid. That this Q is equal to MC delta T. This equation I am going to apply for cold fluid. So if I apply for cold fluid, the equation will become Q is equal to MC CC. And temperature difference for cold fluid, higher temperature minus lower temperature. We know that the cold fluid outlet temperature is more. So it will become TCO minus TCI. So referring to this particular figure. So here in this figure, the TCI is less and TCO is greater. So TCO minus TCI to have a positive temperature difference. So we have written TCO minus TCI. So here also we are knowing that capital CC is nothing but MC CC, and putting in above equation. So if I put in above equation, what will be equation we are getting? Let us see. That what I have done is Q is equal to capital CC, where it was MCCC, into temperature difference for cold fluid. So temperature difference for cold fluid is TCO minus TCI. That's the equation we have got. Rearrange the term for CC. So CC is equal to Q upon TCO minus TCI. This is the equation number 6. So now we have find out value of CH. Now we have find out value of CC. And now putting this value of CH and CC. So CC, we have got Q upon TCO minus TCI. Whereas CH, what we have got CH is Q upon THI minus THO. So CH and CC value I am going to put in this particular equation. And I will get a new equation now as D of delta T is equal to minus DQ into bracket. Into bracket it is 1 upon CH. And 1 upon CH by the equation number 5, we can write that Q upon THI minus THO. That is the value of CH minus. 1 upon Cc. What is the Cc? Here we have find out. Cc is nothing but Q upon TCO minus TCI. That is the equation we have got it. Now simplifying this particular equation. So for simplification, what I will do? This will go on upper side. So equation will become D of a delta T is equal to minus DQ into bracket. This will go above side. So it will become THI minus THO by Q minus TCO minus TCI. So this term I am going to take on upper side. So divided by Q. Like this equation we will get. Next simplification for this. As D of a delta T. D of a delta T minus DQ. This Q is taken common outside. So inside a bracket. What will get in inside bracket? THI minus THO minus TCO minus TCI. So simplifying this equation. THI minus THO. This minus sign go on inside, so it will become minus TCO. It was positive here, so going minus sign, it will become negative. Minus TCO plus TCI. That's the equation we have got it. Now, this DQ is the heat transfer for the small area. Which small area? The small area DA. Okay, so this DQ I can write in other term as the DQ is equal to. This DQ is equal to U dA delta T. So we are knowing the standard equation Q is equal to UA delta T. But if I take a DQ, that is the heat transfer for the small area. So if I take a DQ, it will become dA. The area will become small area. If I take Q only, then this will become A. So Q is the total heat transfer, A is the total area. Okay. So this DQ I am going to put here. This DQ I am going to put here. So equation will become D of a delta T. Is equal to D of delta T is equal to rather than DQ I am going to put minus U dA delta T by Q into bracket. So into bracket I can write that THI, I am going to simplify this, THI minus TCO. So this we can write it simple, THI minus TCO minus. What I am going to write is the THO. So it will become positive because we have taken a minus sign outside. So here it was negative. So as minus sign taken outside, so it will become positive THO minus this TCI. Why TCI? Because this TCI was positive and as I taken minus sign outside, so it will become negative. So just we are rearranging the term THI minus TCO I have taken. And then THO minus TCI we have taken. So we have got this particular equation. Now, separating the delta T terms on left side and other terms this side. So it will become now D of delta T. This delta T on this side. So it will become delta T is equal to minus UDA. Minus UDA by Q into bracket. In the bracket now, rather than THI minus and THO minus TCI, I am going to replace. We have seen already graph as the THI minus TCO is delta T1, whereas the THO minus TCI is delta T2. So with this particular graph, that THI minus TCO is minus delta T1 minus delta T2, because THO minus TCI is delta T2. Now, this is the equation. This is the equation for small area dA. Small area dA. If I want an equation for complete area, for complete area heat transfer will be Q. So for getting for a complete area, so what I have to take? I have to take integration of this equation and integration of this equation. Here the integration will be taken with respect to delta T and here integration will be taken with respect to dA. So when I am going to take integration with respect to delta T, so the limit of delta T is from delta T1 to T2, whereas limit of A is 0 to A. So here we can see that when I consider the starting point of heat exchanger is this one and ending point is this one. So here I consider area is 0 and here area is A. Why the area is 0 here? Because we know that the surface area AS is a perimeter into length. So length at this point is 0. Length at this point is 0 and as length at this point is 0, so the area is 0. Here when it goes for here, the length is L. We are knowing the length is L. So as length L is present there, there is area A. So area varies from 0 to A. When area is varying from 0 to A, how delta T varies? Delta T varies from delta T1 to delta T2. So delta T varies from delta T1 to T2, area varies from 0 to A. These limits I have to consider in this particular equation, that here there is delta T1 to T2 and here there is 0 to A. So next simplification is like this, taking an integration for the above equation. So integration will give you, taking integration of above equation, integration of above equation. So just I am going to repeat the equation which we have already written. D of delta t upon delta t is equal to integration of minus u dA upon q into bracket delta t1 minus delta t2. So here, as we have discussed, the limit for delta t is delta t1 to d2, where the limit for this is 0 to a. Okay, and taking an integration of this one, so how you can determine integration of this one? So it's 1 upon delta t, 1 upon delta t into d of delta t. So 1 upon delta t integration is ln of delta t, where the delta t varies from delta t1 to t2. Whereas integration here, u, q and delta t1, delta t2 is constant. Only dA is the variable. So integration of dA is A, where area varies from 0 to A, as we have discussed, into all other term. What is all other term? U by q into bracket delta t1 minus delta t2. That's the equation we have got it. Now, putting the limit. So after putting the limit, if I put delta t2 minus delta t1, if I put these two limit in this particular equation, it will become ln of delta t2 minus ln of delta t1, and minus sign I can write in the terms of ratio. So it will become ln of delta t2 by delta t1 is equal to, if I put the limit, higher limit minus lower limit, so it will become a minus 0, so it will be a. So I am going to put a here. So equation will become minus ua by q into bracket as delta t1 minus delta. So I am going to rearrange the term. How I am going to rearrange the Q term? I am going to take on this side, and this I am going to take on this side. So what we will get? Q is equal to, Q is equal to UA. This minus sign I am taken on inside. So when this minus sign goes inside, so it will become a delta T2. So this will become positive and this will become negative. Delta T2 minus delta T1 divided by this term. So it will become ln of delta T2 by delta T1. So this term we have got it. So we got in this particular equation, and this is the equation number. If I go back and check the equation number, so this is equation number 7. Now I am going to write one more equation, that we are knowing that UA delta T. So rather than UA delta T, I am going to write UA delta T LM. So what is UA delta T LM? The delta T LM is also called as LMTD. Some of the book they refer as LMTD. So this is LMTD, is called as logarithmic mean temperature difference. So if I compare now equation number 7 and 8, by comparing equation number 7 and 8, I can write that the delta T LM is equal to, so instead of delta T, here UA and here is UA. So rather than this, I have written delta T LM. So I can write, say, delta T LM is nothing but this one. So delta T LM is nothing but delta T2 minus delta T1 divided by ln of delta T2 by delta T1. So this equation is called as LMTD equation for a counter flow heat exchanger, where the delta T1 D2 is the temperature difference at the exit, delta T1 is temperature difference at the inlet, and divided by ln of delta TD, delta T2 by T1. So this is called as LMTD for counter flow heat exchanger. So thus we have derived an equation, important equation for heat exchanger, that's the counter flow heat exchanger. Thank you very much for listening.